After calving, a lot is required from our dairy cows. They go from being a dry cow all of a sudden to being a milk-producing lactating cow. Now, this results in cows needing a lot of energy. Now, most cows are not able to consume enough energy that they need to produce the milk that we're asking of them. So most cows end up in negative energy balance. And this is an issue for many, many dairy cows across the country. A few metabolic disorders will result from this negative energy balance. It could be fatty liver, it could be ketosis, or it could be displaced abomasums, where the fourth stomach moves out of position. So cows that might suffer from fatty liver or ketosis, really the only thing you can do to them is provide them more energy. Now, it might be a supplement that you drench them with propylene glycol, and that will set them right for a couple of days, but it's really about giving them that energy in their diet that they require. Once a cow develops a displaced abomasum, the only real treatment is surgery. And after surgery, if you catch her early, she will recover fairly quickly. Two other issues that are very common after calving is milk fever and retained placenta. Milk fever really is a deficiency in calcium. And if issues do arise, you really have only two options. Is either feed cows some Cal Plus around calving just to boost calcium levels and increase their uptake, or once they go down with milk fever, you have to get the vet out to give them calcium in the vein. Cows respond very well to this calcium treatment, so they'll get up after 5 or 10 minutes, and there's no need to really rush them in getting up. They will get up eventually, don't worry. But it's something they recover from very quickly. But keep in mind that the higher yielding cows are using a lot more calcium in the milk that they produce for us. So they are more prone to get milk fever, and keep an eye on those. The retained placenta is something that is not necessarily an issue. If the cleanings haven't come out in after 24 hours after calving, we talk about retained placenta. These cows are just more prone to get infection of their womb. So metritis or eventually endometritis. Eventually, that will impact our fertility. So, if a cow has retained her placenta, give it a bit of time. Don't try and pull it out. If after 2-3 days after calving, it still hasn't come out, you can try with a little bit of gentle traction. But if it still won't come, don't try and peel it away. Let it fall out, let it deteriorate. Keep an eye on the cow. As long as she's not sick, there's no other treatment needed. Closer to breeding, you just have to get her checked to make sure that she's all clean.